The Galaxy Watch Active 2 and Apple Watch Series 5 are two of the leading smartwatches that most consumers will be looking at this holiday season. What I wanted to do in this video is compare both of these smartwatches. There are 10 categories that I want to measure them up by, and at the end of the video, we should have a winner. Now, I know this is not a fair comparison if you're an Android phone user because the Apple Watch doesn't work on that platform. However, I just want to come out with a clear-cut winner overall of which one is the best watch to get. So each category will have a point system from 0 to 5, and at the end of the video, we'll tally up the scores. To be fair for this comparison, I'm using both the aluminum versions of each watch. These are the baseline models, and I'm using the Apple Watch Series 5 with GPS and LTE, but I have the cellular option turned off for this comparison. Now, starting off with design, both watches are built really well. They have a solid, sturdy construction. Both have an IP68 rating and are good for a depth of up to 50 meters in water. The Apple Watch's design hasn't changed much over the last 5 years. You have the square display, a rotating dial that's called the digital crown, and the Active 2 has a circular display with a touch bezel. Now, handing out scores, for the Apple Watch Series 5, I'm giving it a 4. Apple has continued with this design for several years now and it's become kind of stagnant. And for the Active 2, I'm giving it a score of 4.5. After wearing both watches for about a week now, I've received more compliments for the Active 2 than the Apple Watch. I think it's just because of the rounded display. It just makes it more of an attractive looking watch overall. So the next category is navigation and how these watches allow you to interact with the settings and applications on the watch itself. So the Apple Watch Series 5 has that rotating bezel, which kind of acts like your typical scroll wheel. Pressing on it will take you to either the watch face or the application screen. Double tapping on it will get you to the application that you previously had, and pressing on the side button will show all previously opened apps, and double tapping it will get you to Apple Pay. Now, with the Galaxy Watch Active 2, you have that digital rotating bezel, which is something Samsung introduced in this model, and then you also have a back button and home button. Now, handing out scores for this category, I'm going to say they're both a 4.5. They handle navigations fluidly, and I can get to applications and settings really quickly with both watches. Now, the next category is software. The Apple Watch Series 5 is running watchOS 6, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 is running Tizen OS 4. Now, the operating systems for both of these watches have come a long way over the last couple years, and I can't tell a difference on which one's faster or snappier. I think they're both really good operating systems for what they do. Now, I do give a slight nod to the Apple Watch Series 5 in this category, and that's mainly due to third-party support. You get more fully fleshed out applications that are ready to use for the watch. When browsing the Galaxy App Store, I just couldn't find the same quality of apps like I could on the App Store for the Apple Watch Series 5. So in this category, the Apple Watch Series 5 gets a 4.5 out of 5, and the Galaxy Active 2 gets a 4 out of 5. So the next category is notifications. Now, both watches allow you to customize which notifications will show up on your wrist, and they're both basically just mimicking what you'd see on your phone. So text messages, phone calls, emails, they kind of pop up similar on both watches. To me, there's not a clear-cut winner in this category, so I'm gonna say it's a tie. The next category is storage. The Apple Watch Series 5 is a clear-cut winner here as it has 32 gigs of onboard storage, up 16 gigs from the Series 4, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 only comes with 4 gigs of onboard storage, and half of that's used for the operating system. The Apple Watch Series 5 gets a 5 out of 5, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 gets a 2. So the next category is always-on display. Now, this is a new feature that was introduced in the Apple Watch Series 5. I know a lot of people will keep this option turned off to save battery life, but it is a good option to have if you just want to have an always-on display so you don't have to constantly turn your wrist to wake up the watch. Now, I'm going to give a slight nod to the Galaxy Watch Active 2. It has a default watch face with a second hand that stays on even when the always-on display is activated. I didn't see any watch face for the Apple Watch Series 5 that had that feature. So the Apple Watch Series 5 gets a 4, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 gets a 4.5. Now, the next category is battery life. Both of these are the smaller 40 millimeter versions. I was able to get about 16 to 18 hours with about 25% remaining on both watches. So to me, it's a tie. I would give them about 3 out of 5 for both. I am still not impressed with the battery life. I would love for this to be a full 2-day watch, and I didn't want to have to compromise by getting the larger version. So to me, they kind of score pretty low. If you can't get 2 days out of a watch, I think that you shouldn't score them high. So yeah, they both get a 3 in my book. So the next category is health tracking. Now, both watches have been marketed for the active individual, and I think that they do a pretty good job at measuring your heart rate throughout the day and tracking your steps. I did get a slightly different readout with my step patterns. I got a little bit higher with the Galaxy Watch Active 2 than the Apple Watch Series 5. I do like that they have daily reminders to stand up and breathe and whatnot. And I also like that both watches have their own health app, so you can track your weekly or monthly activity based on your running and heart rate and everything else that you do that the watch can track. I think they're both really good at keeping you active. So for me, they're both a 4.5 out of 5. And so the next category is a pretty big one, and that's customization. Both watches give you the opportunity to customize it to your wardrobe and fit it into your lifestyle so that it makes sense to you and it's your own personal watch. The Apple Watch Series 5 comes in several different materials, all the way from aluminum to ceramic, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 only has aluminum and stainless steel. Now, the Apple Watch Series 5 also has several different watch band configurations. You have everything from these soft rubber bands to these expensive leather bands. Now, the only problem with this is that they're proprietary as far as the bands itself and the way they interlock with the watch. And so one of the benefits of the Galaxy Watch Active 2 is that you don't have proprietary bands. You can use pretty much any standard watch band that has a pin connector to it. And so this opens up to a wide variety of watch bands that are out there, either through Amazon or through local jewelry stores. And so you're really not tied down to proprietary watch bands with the Galaxy Watch Active 2. And so the second part of this category is the watch faces themselves. Now, Apple does provide a wide variety of watch faces. However, they're the same watch faces that you've seen time and time again, with just a couple additions each year. With the Samsung Galaxy Watch Active 2, you're open to thousands and thousands of watch faces in the Galaxy App Store. And so customizing your watch face is really just up to your personal preference. And you can browse the Galaxy App Store for hours and hours and hours and never even touch the surface of what's really out there. So to me, this is a big part of customizing your watch, is looking at the watch face itself. And so I have to give the nod to the Galaxy Watch Active 2 for this one in particular. And so the Apple Watch Series 5 gets a 3 for customization, and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 gets a 5. And so the last category in this smartwatch comparison is price. Now, just comparing the baseline models, the Galaxy Watch Active 2 currently retails for $279 and $299 for the 40mm and 44mm, and the Apple Watch Series 5 retails for $399 or $429 for the 40mm and 44mm. So based on the price alone, you're saving about $130 currently for the Galaxy Watch Active 2. So I give the Galaxy Watch Active 2 a 4.5 out of 5, and the Apple Watch Series 5 a 3.5 out of 5 based on the price. Now, running up the scores for all 10 categories, I give the Apple Watch a 40 out of 50 and the Galaxy Watch Active 2 a 40.5 out of 50, which makes the Galaxy Watch Active 2 the winner in this comparison. I think both watches are so good that it's really hard to find a clear-cut winner, but I think the Galaxy Watch Active 2 edges out just really based on design and customization. I love the rounded display and just the endless amounts of watch faces that are available in the Galaxy App Store. You can really truly customize this watch to fit your personality. And I also want to reiterate that I'm just comparing the smartwatches themselves. I didn't include smartphones because I didn't want to have to worry about saying, look, the Apple Watch doesn't work with Android, and you do have limitations with a Galaxy Watch on iOS. I just wanted to compare the smartwatches themselves, and I feel like the Galaxy Watch Active 2 is just a little bit better at what it can do than the Apple Watch Series 5. Please let me know what you think in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is Tech Jungle, and I will see y'all in the next one. Y'all take care.